How's it going, everybody? I'm here with my little Rotarycraft setup here, and I wanted to try to automate a little bit. And I noticed something in here that I hadn't seen before. It's pneumatic item pump. And I'm thinking that this is going to work for moving stuff from one machine to another. So I'm going to give it a shot. And there's always, you know, use item ducts or item conduits, but if I can do this, why the hell not? So, I think I want it to go that way. That looks like it would go that direction. It says it needs power for these, but it doesn't say where, but it needs butt tons of speed. Holy crap, I didn't see that. Hold on. Before I lose something down there, let's put that right there. Alright, so... Oh, this puts out exactly the 256. Okay, never mind. Alright, so if I put this down without being there... don't really see where it shows a power in... So let's set it back up the way we had it here. And we'll have to make a lever for it. And I'm probably going to have to put this here to power it. I don't want to touch that friction heater. Alright, so that's going to power that. Let's drop a thing of iron ore in here and see what it does. So let that run. Let's see, ignore MBT, use ore dictionary. It says it has power. Ignore metadata. And blacklist. We want to blacklist nothing. So, pneumatic pump is used to rapidly transfer items between inventories. If an item pump has an inventory behind it, it will check in front of it for a valid receiving inventory. If it finds another pump, it follows the pump's frontal direction, repeats the process. One item per tick per kilowatt of input power. Alright, and it moved it. And did it really move it over there? It's not in there. Let's try another one. There's a zombie at my door. Let's try this one more time now that we're done reading and can actually look at it. If so, I am definitely going to use these for here. Let's see. I want it like that. Okay, it's done. It's moved, and it's in the furnace. Check that out. That is awesome. So... that's going to take care of doing that. Now I need to get another grinder made to go over here to put my sugar cane in to make sugar. And then we'll make another DC engine to put behind this to move it into here. And for right now we're using leaves, and apparently Theosis has been beaten up again. He loves his internet. His ping's a little bad, especially going all the way over to Germany. So now, the way this is, it's got like a thing here. I should actually be able to use this for both and not need this hopper. So let's take this hopper out of here. Let's move this over here. Now that would leave direction. Now if I put these in here, apparently that's not an inventory. It won't let me hold them in there. Let's move this over a block. And yes, my inventory's full. Ain't it always? Alright, now we're gonna put this in here. And move this engine to right there. And now we gotta play with the pipes a little bit here. Get some water in here. And just give me that pipe. I'll deal with cleaning the rest of that up in a little bit. I'll move this one over here. Turn it on. And now eventually I will get to the point where I can make a lot of power and make ways that I can get rid of these DCs, because there's going to be three of them across here. But for right now, this will work. Let's put these in here. This here. Two redstone. Make some base panels. Alright, you sit there. And we'll make another one of these. And yeah, in this pack, we didn't turn off the need for this table, so it's definitely needed here. Put that there. Make another lever, which technically I could just run redstone across the floor here, but you never know what might happen. You might want to turn something off. So there we go. Got all of them on. And if I put a hopper up here, that will hopefully do this. I don't know if it will or not. If not, then I'm going to have to change this again. It doesn't look like it's going to now. Can you hopper in from the top? I don't believe so. Oh, yes, you can. Alright, so that'll work. So that's where the dry material go. This will pull that stuff over. And we'll actually put another one there for now. That'll be where our dirt comes into. And we need to look at a composter, I think it's called. That's going to be one of the next things I need to make, because it'll make dirt for us. Very simple to make. If I look up dirt here, I can do it with IC2 Classic from Plant Balls. I can apparently, okay, there it is, compost and sand. So any meat products and yeast, or potatoes, any food products, it looks like. Oh, we can use freaking zombie flesh and eggs. That is awesome. Crazy will always have lots of eggs for us. Flowers, mushrooms. We can put leaves in there too. So that will be awesome. And then sand, if I remember correctly, we can actually get sand right out of cobble. And we have butt tons of that. This is from SP API mod. So we can squeeze gravel, get sand and flint out of it that way. 90% chance of the sand. We can macerate cobble right into sand. So we're going to get into, we can also grind gravel Alright. Centrifuge, we can get it out of dirt, but we really don't want to do that. And crusher recipe. Alright, so we're going to make us a IC2 Classic Macerator. So, basic macerator, nothing, you know, too crazy about this here. Just re-smelting iron over to get the refined iron, just like you would. And for anybody that's been watching me do the stuff from IC2 Classic in 110, this hasn't been back. It hasn't been backported to 1710. There are some things that are going to be the same or similar, and there's some things that are going to be a bit different, like uranium. You have your different rods here, like what I have in there, so we have ways of enriching our uranium. And I actually talked to Spiger and made sure that he felt that it was okay, because we have thorium in here, and we're going to add a way to, with Mind Tweaker and Mod Tweaker, a way to make this enriched charcoal uranium ingot here with thorium, because it's basically the same thing. So, better than iron. Getting started on IC2 Classic. I am going to kind of jump around mods just a little bit. I started with Tinkers, obviously, to get my tools, because when I'm not playing with Greg Tech, I kind of like having Tinkers, especially if I have a Guana Tweaks. Guana Tweaks gives you a nice way that you have to actually level up a bit, which is something that I enjoy having to do, having a kind of a way you have to progress. So, throw this in here and go ahead and get our composter out of here. Now, it looks like this thing has absolutely no power requirement. Allows discarded food, plant matter, other organics to be broken down into something that, while appearing to you, is highly valuable by plants and is often very conductive to their growth. This process requires yeast to facilitate the process. But it looks like I'm not going to have enough heat here. I'm probably going to have to find a warmer place to put this, or get a heater for it. We will check that out a little later. If you notice, this thing is running super slow, and it's because of the temperature. It looks like, though, for some reason, the temperature is higher over here. Not real sure why. They're, you know, both in extreme hills. The river out here, over here is forest, so that might actually be warmer. And I think it goes by height, and we're a little higher up here. But yeah, it still says 25°C there. So we'll have to see. Let's see, do we have a flower we can throw in here? We got flowers everywhere. There's a dandelion. Let's go ahead and throw it in there and see if it'll do anything. And we need a piece of yeast. We got plenty of that in here. And now I got my fermenter achievement. So we'll throw that in there, and I'm sure it's not going to do anything, but we'll let it try. And we need to get a little bit of copper here to make some wires. We're going to have to make a generator to power this. So we'll have to get some tin as well. I have this other hopper. Let's go ahead and use it. Throw that on top of there. And 10. Go ahead and grab a few of each of these and throw them in there. Let them get processed up. I don't have a way of pulling them out of here at the moment. But we will work on that. I'll probably put another pneumatic here with a chest or something. That's the wrong direction. Need to go this direction. There we go. It looks like Theosis is back and done with his dying spree for the moment. Glad to see that. I hate to see it when somebody has a hard time. Because of ping, I used to go through that all the time. He's listening while I record here, so I don't want anybody to think I'm talking shit about him behind his back or anything. He definitely hears every word I say. I'll have to show you his little hobble he's got out there. You said you got some sticky resin for me today, right? Can't remember where he said he put it. So I definitely need to get me some rubber done up. I do near the Tinker's area. Okay. Thank you, dude. There's his little Canadian hovel, his little house. And he's doing a lot of tree farming. One of the next things we need to get done on here is automating the coke ovens. I built these yesterday. But I'm going to let Junior take care of them. I actually got to come on here and help him later because he went in the nether and somehow managed to die. I think he hit a lag spike because Junior doesn't die a whole lot. So when he dies, it's usually something insane that had to take him out. Let's grab some more of this and make us some more steel. You can see I got steel armor on. That's because I was going in the nether with Junior and figured I might just need it. Out around here, I'm usually pretty good with not needing armor, but going in the nether, being on a German server, you never know what's going to happen. I actually died for the second time to a wither skeleton, and it almost had to be lag because I had full health, but I withered away, and I definitely should not have, at least in my opinion. There we go. And probably ought to put a chest there. It says it checks for inventory, so maybe that means it won't throw shit on the ground. But just in case, we're going to make a chest anyways, because we need somewhere for it to go. So let's see here. Alright, thanks, dude. So now it's got somewhere to go. Now, does it have to have an update for it to do it? Oh, why is it not turning? It's got power from right here. Oh, it was because the power was already on, I guess. Alright, so now everything looks like it's transferring around like it should. Now let's get some wires made and get our generator made, and we'll go ahead and make an extractor and a macerator. 3, 4, 5, 6. Holy crap. You can't use that kind of furnace to do this, I take it? extractor smelter. Yeah, you just throw it in a furnace and it does it, but apparently Rotarycraft doesn't. Oh, it's trying to pull it before it can. Why is it doing that? And where is the tin I put in here? It's not going in that way. Okay, so you can't hopper in through the top, apparently. Okay. Can you go in through this direction? Yes, okay. So let's throw this stuff in here and let's see if that gets pulled out of there too quick. Because if so, we're definitely going to have to use something different for that. You just thought that Reika would have thought of something like that? Alright, so the tin flakes are done. And yeah, they just got sent right over, so that absolutely will not work. Huh, that is very strange. So we're either going to have to put a item duct here, or we can actually put a hopper underneath it and pull out that way, but it'll just be easy to make a item duct. Let's grab a couple lead here and we'll just make us a item duct to do it. And there's our tin. Let's grab these tin flakes and throw them in here. Let that all get done. You'll notice my sound is kind of low. It's because of these machines. They are very, very loud. And I didn't want to blow y'all's eardrums. Let's go over here and use Junior's alloy smelter. Nobody tell him. Somebody's cooking another brick, apparently. And let's see. Has he got any power stored up here? He's got a little bit. I can actually put some more coal in there. If I remember correctly, Theosis said we had a little bit of... Hi, buddy. How are you? Would you like to die? Give me a sec. I'll help you out. If you came here to die, I'll be more than obliged to help you out. Let's see. Charcoal. We have coal. We have charcoal. Give me a little bit of that. Junior's working on making a windmill for his little Ender IO setup over there so he doesn't have to use his generator. And he's got all kinds of different ideas of things he wants to do. And when he gets back on and gets a little bit of work done, maybe we'll do a video and show you what he's doing over here on his side. I told him that this was his building, but this is my side of his building. That's his side of his building. So he's got to deal with me being over here. I don't think he was too fond of the idea, but you know, that's the way Dad works. He's a big meanie. Ain't no way I'm building my own daggone shop. I hate making shops. Alright, so we'll make our first circuit here. And not itches. There we go. That's the one we want. So we got our circuit. Our machine block. Gravel. Do we have gravel? I need one more of them. If I was gravel, there I am. I need three of them, actually. You see this ore? This is a really weird looking ore. It's from that new, what's it called? It's a space mod. What the hell? Advanced rocketry. That's what it's called. Takes me a second sometimes. You're an idiot and put that in the wrong machine. All right, let's try this again. That's supposed to go in the SAG mill, not in the smelter. All right, so we're gonna need two of these. What? You coming to the door too? Come here. I'll give you a whacking. Everybody just shows up and wants their ass beat. I don't think I'd ever go and, hey, could you please do me a favor? Beat my ass. Oh, yeah, no problem. Stop on by tomorrow. I'll hook you up. Now, I am trying to actually get my achievements here. I don't think I've ever gotten all of them. And I definitely need to make a generator first. I was kind of worried about that. Let's make another crafting table. Because I need one anyways, because I want to make a project table. So let's just make a regular crafting table for now. And I know I need two more redstone for the battery. Let's hook up the generator here. Alright, so iron furnace or that way. Same amount of power, same amount of everything. Just a different way to do it. This is 5 and 3. This is 8. That takes a furnace and a furnace, so doesn't really matter how you do it. We are going to have to make some more refined iron, though. So grab 8 pieces of iron here and throw that in. Let's get the copper out of there. And the lead's going through so we can make our pipe. I would have to say this is the one thing I kind of don't like about this furnace. I love the friction furnace, but I don't like the fact that it just spits XP at you all the time. I actually like to earn my XP by going out and killing shit, not standing in front of this furnace all day. But, you know, it happens. Alright, so while we're waiting on that, let's go ahead and make this item duct, which should just be... Is that how you make these things? Or is it tin you gotta use? Ain't lead for, like, liquids. Huh. Let's go look. I swore that's how you make them. Item duct. I know that I don't need the... Can make the... Where's the frickin' this one? Okay, so lead inside. Alright. It was something like that. It's been a while. Give an old guy a break, you know? I play Greg Tech most of the time. These recipes are easy. Now, question is this going to pull it as quick as that damn pneumatic pipe did? Throw that in there. And now we need one of those, servos. We need one of these things. So, iron, redstone, glass, couple nuggies. So, I'll do this. Piece of glass. Piece of redstone. Two of those gives us two servos. And we're good to go. Now, put this on here, and we tell it to enable, and now it should pull it right out of there. I'm guessing it's not because it has to come out the bottom. Just like the hopper. This is a vanilla furnace. And I can't remember how you actually automate them. I've never done it in vanilla. Let's go ahead and get this here taken care of. And we're going to need to grab our redstone. And so we need this. Oh, I don't have enough wire made. Hold on. Hold your ass there, buddy. Gotta make more wire. For anybody that's used to playing with IC2 Experimental and wasn't around for the classic days, this is how you make an RE battery. You don't use tin cable, you use copper cable, because copper is the low voltage in IC2 Classic. So there is our generator. We'll go ahead and put this over here on the wall. And we're going to want to make a bat box for this. But for right now, we're just going to make the macerator. We'll sit it right next to it. Come out here and grab us a little bit more of this charcoal. Power that bad boy up. Which we will probably be on lava power for that as soon as possible. Because I like my lava power. Very much so. And we'll look at other ways of powering it, like a reactor, as soon as possible. But for now, we'll just use regular plain old charcoal. And we'll throw a stack of this in there. And that'll start making us some sand for use over here. Now, we have got to figure out how exactly we're going to get stuff out of here. So, let's break that out. Grab a couple pieces of this. Now, if I do something like this, let's go ahead and put some more iron in there to be done. You know what? We got this poor lead. It's poor lead. I feel sorry for it. Sitting here in a box. Let's go ahead and throw it in the furnace. Get it taken care of. And I know we don't need a wrench to pick this up, so we'll go ahead and just grab it. And we'll put this down here. Put that on there, and ignore redstone. That'll turn it on. And we will grab another pipe here. We're going to put it here. And we're going to go ahead and move this chest right on top of it. We'll see if that does it. Now, is that going to pull out of there? Apparently not. Now, I know daggone well Buildcraft can pull out of here. What the hell is this mod's problem? Oh, there we go. They're going. Okay, so apparently it does have to be from the bottom. It just took it a minute to get started. So, okay, there we go. We have that automated now. Go ahead and put our floor back here. So now we can dump our ores in here. They'll get cooked and put right in there. And eventually we'll have it connected to our storage drawers. I want to talk to Theosis when he's not too busy and see if he wants to come and help me make some of the compacting drawers. We've got plenty of iron, so I want to make a bunch of these for our metal. That way, like the lead there, we could just have it go in there and it automatically make it into the ingots, nuggets, blocks, things like that. And we got poor copper here. We might as well throw it in here and get it ready to go as well. And I think that's going to be it for this one. We got a little bit of work done. We got our fermenter started. Like I said, I want to get another shredder over here, grinder, actually, to grind up and make the sugar. And I'm either going to put another furnace or work on getting a way to get this into that furnace. Not sure yet which I'm going to do. But we're going to do one or the other, because we have to cook this sludge here into the ethanol crystals, and then we will be using that as fuel, but we're mainly going to be using it for the gas engine. And once I get that made, a lot of these steam engines are going to go. We're going to upgrade to gas engines around here. They're a little less noisy and they put out a lot more power, so our things will run a bit faster. So maybe we'll work on that in the next video. But for now, that's it. I'm going to make me an extractor and a bat box for my IC2 Classic, so that'll be done in the next one. And I will see you guys later. Hope you enjoy this series. Later.